Hello students, today I am going to discuss about a very important physiological process which is called as glycolysis. Glycolysis is a major step in the process of respiration, where the respiration is a very complicated process which involves more than 25 steps, and this presentation is very basic in its nature, which will be suitable for undergraduate students, where we are not going to discuss much about its reaction natures and control mechanisms, regulations and all, but we are going to discuss much more with respect to the conversion of compounds, steps involved into that. Glycolysis is a universal process which takes place in all kind of organisms, irrespective of whether they are prokaryotes and eukaryotes. And it is also called as EMP pathway, to honor the scientist who elucidated this particular process. That is Emden, Meyerhoff and Parnas. Glycolysis, the term, if we go to the etymology, we can see that glyco refers to glucose, that is sugar, and lysis refers to breaking down. And breaking down of the sugar into pyruvic acid, this is what the glycolysis process. And it takes place in the cytoplasm of the organisms. It takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell, where it is a cellular process. The first reaction of the glycolysis begins like glucose undergoes phosphorylation by the addition of ATP, which gets converted into glucose 6-phosphate. And this particular reaction will be mediated by an enzyme known as hexokinase. And this is a irreversible reaction, which is a beginning of the glycolysis. And after glucose gets converted into glucose 6-phosphate, with the help of enzyme fructose isomerase, the glucose 6-phosphate gets converted into fructose 6-phosphate. This is a reaction which involves isomerization of aldoses into ketoses, where the glucose is an aldose and fructose is a ketose. The third very important reaction is addition of one more ATP into the glycolytic pathway to the fructose 6-phosphate. In the position number 1, ATP will get added, and the product will be fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. This particular reaction is mediated by phosphofructokinase, and ADP will be released in this particular reaction. After fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is formed, it undergoes a cleavage that refers to from glucose to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, all the compounds are having 6 carbon atoms. But in the fourth reaction, that is the cleavage reaction, in the presence of enzyme aldolase, it cleaves or it breaks the fructose 1,6-bisphosphate into 2 compounds of 3 carbon atoms, namely dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Dihydroxyacetone phosphate can be abbreviated as DHAP and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate as 3PGA. Fifth reaction is again a isomerization reaction where the DHAP gets isomerized into 3PGA, and this particular reaction is mediated with the enzyme called triose phosphate isomerase. And from the reaction number one, that is the conversion of glucose to glucose 6 phosphate, to the reaction number 5, that is the conversion or isomerization of DHAP to 3PGA, we call them as investment reactions, because though in the respiration reaction we say ATP is liberated, that is it is a catabolic process where ATP is generated, out of this 5 reaction, in the first and third reaction we can see that the consumption of ATP by the glycolytic pathway. That's why this particular 5 reactions are called as investment reactions. After this, in the 6th reaction, there will be a dehydrogenation, that is the nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, abbreviated as NAD, and in its oxidized state it is stated as NAD plus, and in reduced state it is termed as NADH. In 6th state, dehydrogenation takes place along with addition of inorganic phosphate, and the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate becomes 1,3-phosphoglyceric acid. So due to the dehydrogenation, the aldehyde component gets converted into acid component. The conversion of 7th reaction is very important reaction, where the 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid releases one of its phosphate group and becomes 3-phosphoglyceric acid, and this is the first reaction where we can see the generation of adenosine triphosphate, that is ATP. In the 8th reaction, the position shift takes place, forming 3-phosphoglyceric acid to 2-phosphoglyceric acid. Reaction number 9, we can see that the conversion of 2-phosphoglyceric acid into phosphoenol pyruvic acid by the enzyme called enolase. And the 10th reaction, again very important reaction with respect to the glycolysis is concerned, because one more ATP will be liberated in this particular reaction, where the 2-phosphoenol pyruvate gets converted into pyruvic acid in the presence of pyruvic kinase enzyme, forming one molecule of ATP. Thus, in the 10 steps of glycolysis, we can get pyruvate at the end. And from reaction number 6 to 8, we can see that all these reactions, for a completion of one cycle of glycolysis, there are 2 reactions are involved, as there is a conversion of DHAP into 3PGA in 5th reaction. As a result, at the end of glycolysis, the one glucose molecule, which is a 6 carbon compound, gives rise to 2 pyruvates or pyruvic acids, which are 3 carbon compounds, and this is what glycolysis, and energetics of glycolysis will be continued later. Thank you.